Happy morning, children. Today, Wednesday. I am Anulakshmi, your English teacher in Vital Matriculation School. Hope you all doing well, right? Had your breakfast? We have to live in a healthy way, so don't skip your breakfast. Okay, children. Today, we are going to see the recall of supplementary reader and its book bag exercise. First, you have to take your note pen with the book, okay? Now, just I read the passage now. You have to listen carefully. On Monday morning, this novel is adapted from The Adventures of Tom Sawyer by Mark Twain. Who is the characters in the novel? Tom, Auntie Polly, Mary, and can you remember? Tom, Auntie Polly, Mary, Sid, Joe Harper, Huckleberry Finn, Becky Thatcher. You have to see that character in the novel. Tom Sawyer. He is the main character. Sid, Tom's half brother. Mary, Tom's cousin sister. Joe Harper, Tom's friend. Huckleberry Finn, Tom's friend. Becky Thatcher, Tom's school friend. Auntie Polly, sister of his dead brother. And then the about the author. The author's original name is Samuel Langorne Clemens. His pen name, Mark Twain. He was born on 30th November 1835, Florida, Missouri, at United States. United States, nothing but it is America. His works, humorist, entrepreneur, publisher, and lecturer. He was died on 21st April 1910, Reading, Connecticut, at United States, America. Now let's read the passage. On Monday morning, adapted from The Adventures of Tom Sawyer by Mark Twain. Monday morning found Tom Sawyer miserable. Monday morning always found him so, because it began another week slow suffering in school. He generally began that day with wishing he had had no holiday in between. It made the going into prison again so much worse. Tom lay thinking. Presently it occurred to him that he wished he was sick. Then he could stay home from school. He examined himself. No sickness was found, and he investigated again. This time he could detect stomach ache, but it soon grew feeble and presently died wholly away. He reflected further. Suddenly he discovered something. One of his upper front teeth was loose. This was lucky. He was about to begin to groan as a trotter, as he called it, when it occurred to him that if he came into court with that argument, his aunt would pull it out and that would hurt. So he thought he would hold the tooth in reserve for the present and seek further. Nothing offered for some little time, and then he remembered hearing the doctor tell about a certain thing that laid up a patient for 2 or 3 weeks and threatened to make him lose a finger. So the boy eagerly drew his sore toe. From under the sheet and held it up for inspection. But now he did not know the necessary symptoms. However, it seemed well worthwhile to chance it. So he fell groaning with considerable spirit, but Sid slept on unconscious. Tom groaned louder and fancied that he began to feel pain in the toe. No result from Sid. Tom was panting with his excursion by this time. He took a rest and then swelled himself up and fetched a succession of admirable groans. Sid snored on. Tom was aggravated. He said, "Sid, Sid," and shook him. This course worked well, and Tom began to groan again. Sid yawned, stretched, then brought himself upon his elbow with a snort and began to stare at Tom. Tom went on groaning. Sid said, "Tom," said Tom. No response. "Here, Tom, what is the matter, Tom?" And he shook him and looked in his face anxiously. Tom moaned out, "Oh, don't sit, don't shake me. Why, what's the matter, Tom? I must call Auntie." "No, never mind." Again, I can read. You have to listen these two lines. It is important. "Don't shake me. Why? What's the matter, Tom? I must call Auntie." "No, never mind. It will be over by and by, maybe. Don't call anybody." "But I must." "Don't groan so, Tom. It's awful. How long you been this way?" "Hearts. Ouch. Oh, don't stare so. Sid, you'll kill me." "Tom, why? Why didn't you wake me sooner?" "Oh, Tom, don't it make my flesh crawl to hear you? What is the matter?" "I forgive you for everything, Sid." Groan. "Everything you have ever done to me. When I am gone." "Oh, Tom, you aren't dying, are you?" "Don't, Tom. Oh, don't, maybe." "I forgive everybody, Sid." "Tell them so, Sid." "And Sid, you give my window sash and my cat with one eye to that new girl that's come to town and tell her." But Sid had snatched his clothes and gone. Tom was suffering in reality now. His imagination was working well, and so his groans had gathered quite a genuine tone. Sid flew downstairs and said, "Oh, Auntie Polly, come. Tom's dying, dying." "Yes, don't wait, come quick." "Rubbish, I don't believe it." But she fled upstairs nevertheless with Sid and Mary at her heels, and her face grew wild too, and her lip trembled. When she reached the bedside, she said, "You, Tom? Tom, what's the matter with you?" "Oh, Auntie, What's the matter with you? What is the matter with you, child? Oh, auntie, my sore toes dying. The old lady sank down into a chair and laughed a little, then cried a little, then did both together. This made her feel better and she said, Tom, what a turn you did give me. Now you shut up that nonsense and climb out of this. The groan stopped and the pain vanished from the toe. The boy felt a little foolish and he said, Auntie Polly, it seemed dying and it hurt so. I never minded my tooth at all. Your tooth indeed, what's the matter with your tooth? One of them is loose and it aches perfectly awful. There now, don't begin that groaning again. Open your mouth well. Your tooth is loose, but you are not going to die from that. Mary, get me a silk thread and a chunk of fire out of the kitchen. Tom said, Oh, please, Auntie, don't pull it out. It don't hurt anymore. I wish I may never stir if it does. Please don't, Auntie. I don't want to stay home from school. Oh, you don't you? So all this row was because you thought you had get to stay home from school and go fishing. Tom, I love you so, and you seem to try every way you can to break my whole heart with your mischief. But this time the dental instruments were ready. The old lady made one end of the silk thread fast to Tom's tooth with the loop and tied the other to the bedpost. Then she caught hold of the chunk of fire and suddenly pushed it almost into the boy's face. The tooth was hanging loosely by the bedpost now. Now, see the glossary. What is the meaning of panting? Panting means breathing quickly. Exertion, effort. Aggravated, irritated. Snort, a cry made to show unhappiness. Anxiously, tensely. Loop, curve. Next, name the speaker. Now, I said the dialogue and speaker. Lines from this lesson. No, never mind. It will be over by and by, maybe. Don't call anybody. Who said this dialogue? Yes, this dialogue said by Tom. Who's Tom? You have to write down in your book. It makes my flesh crawl to hear you. What is the matter? This dialogue who said? This dialogue said by Sid. S-I-D. Sid. Your tooth indeed. What's the matter with your tooth? This dialogue who said? Auntie Polly. Aunt Polly. Then write true or false against each statement. Tom enjoyed Monday mornings as he had to go to school. Is it true or false? Is it false? Because he wants not to go to school. Tom's first groan woke up Sid from his sound sleep. No, it is also false. Tom wanted to give his dog with one eye to the new girl who had come to town. Here, no dog. That is a cat, right? So it is also false. And Tipoli sent Sid to fetch the dentist. No, it is also false statement. Then read the following passage and answer the question. Tom lay thinking. Presently it occurred to him that he wished he was sick. Then he could stay home from home. He examined himself. He found no symptoms or sickness and he investigated again. This time he felt he had a stomach ache, but it soon grew feeble and presently died wholly away. He reflected further. Okay, now let's see the question. Why did Tom wish that he were sick? Why? Because Tom wanted to stay away from school and so he wished to be sick. So he wished to, he was sick. This is the first question answer. Second, what was the result of Tom's self-examination? He found no symptoms or sickness. This is the second question answer. What did he deduct? Again, what was the result of Tom's self-examination? He found no symptoms or sickness, and this was the result of his self-examination. Third question, what did he detect? He detected stomach ache. He detected a stomach ache, which later soon grew feeble. Which later soon grew feeble. This is the third question. Next, think and answer. You have to write it in your note, these three questions, okay? All of you doing? You have to mark your book and write it in your note, okay? Don't forget. First, see this. First question, how did Sid show his affection towards Tom? Sid showed his affection towards Tom by trying to console him with his words that Tom is not dying. Sid showed his affection towards Tom by trying to console him with his words that Tom is not dying. No. Second question. Did Auntie Polly believe Tom's groaning? Why? No. No. Aunt Polly did not believe in Tom's groaning because of his little foolishness. He said that his sore toe is dying. So, Auntie Polly don't believe Tom. And then third question, what did Auntie Polly do to relieve Tom's toothache? Auntie Polly asked Mary to get her silk thread and a chunk of fire out of the kitchen to pull the tooth in order to relieve Tom's toothache. Auntie Polly asked Mary to get her silk thread and a chunk of fire out of the kitchen to pull the tooth in order to relieve the Tom's toothache. Next, choose the correct answer. Let's see. Let's choose. Tom pretended his toe was dying in order to miss school. Why miss school? Tom pretended his toe was dying in order to miss school. And Tipali pulled Tom's tooth out with dash. A piece of thread. Tom was miserable on Monday morning because he hated going to school. Project and connecting to self. When you come at school, that time we will see that. Next, step to success. Are you all having book? You have to listen. Siblings. Who is siblings? Brothers and sisters. Who is siblings? Brothers and sisters called as siblings. Kith and kin. Friends and blood relatives. Kith and kin means friends and blood relatives. Friends and blood relatives called as kith and kin. A chip of the old block as parents called as a chip of the old block. Two peas in a pot. Two peas in a pot like twins. Twins called as the two peas in a pot. Breadwinner means earning person. So many people have earning person as our father. Somebody's have also mother also, okay? So earning person or father. Forefather means nothing but great grandfather is called forefathers. Then arrange the words according to their degrees of meaning. First, excited, thrilled, eager. Excited, thrilled, and eager. Third, and second one is